This was Doi Tung in 1981. And this is Doi Tung presently. The shifting hill tribe farmers, who in the past had no choice but to destroy the natural mountains to survive, now understand that living in harmony with the natural environment will provide long-term economic benefits. This is the outcome of the Doi Tung development project, initiated in 1988 by the late mother of the reigning king, Her Royal Highness Princess Sinakarintara. It was her wish to reforest Doi Tung so that people and forests can coexist. Nowadays, the hill tribe people's standard of living has improved tremendously. They have a sense of belonging, steady work, and legitimate incomes to provide for their families. Most importantly, they are happy. Local farmers now harvest Arabica coffee and macadamia nuts in place of opium cultivation. 20 years ago, it was hard to imagine that this very important watershed area could even be revived. Doi Tung is located in the notorious Golden Triangle, formerly the world's largest producer of opium and opiates. The cultivating practices of the hill tribe minorities left the forest destroyed, yet did not provide them with sufficient food to feed their families for the year. To fill in the gap, opium and important medicine became their only cash crop. The market came right to their doors. Raw opium mushroomed into more dangerous drug cartels. Human trafficking, AIDS, other diseases followed. The people got embroiled in a downward spiral. Some became addicts, others had to sell their daughters to survive. The future was very bleak. Until Her Royal Highness, the Princess Mother, came to this desolate area. She saw through the root cause of the problems, poverty and the lack of opportunity in life. She was determined to put an end to this vicious cycle of illness, poverty and ignorance. It was then that she declared, "I will reforest Doi Tung." The Doi Tung development project covers an area of 150 square kilometers and accommodates approximately 11,000 people of various ethnicities and has a 30-year time frame. Both government and private sectors have joined together to work for the common goal, following Her Royal Highness's direction to help the people so they can help themselves. The project works to provide the locals with better livelihood options and opportunities in education. The healing of lives in Doi Tung started simultaneously for both man and nature. Drug addicts were rehabilitated so that they could have another chance at leading a dignified, productive life. The environment was revived by the hands of the destroyers. Opium farmers were hired to reforest the mountains, and immediately, income from an illicit source was replaced with an illicit one. Watershed, subsistence, and economic forests were planted. Arabica coffee and macadamia trees were selected for their high market demand and value-adding potential. They also grew well under the same conditions as opium. To provide steady income opportunities for both genders of all ages, the project has diversified into other labor-intensive areas of agriculture, such as plant tissue culture, horticulture, floriculture, value adding to agricultural products, such as food processing, and value creation of traditional skills of handicrafts. Basic skills and techniques of local artisans have been improved upon by designers to meet with global market demands. We have the endorsement from the United Nations Office on Drugs and Crime, the UNODC, on all the products which we sell. Labels signify that the sale of this product contributes to the achievement of a drug-free world. Through alternative sustainable development, villages who once depended on opium production and use can now earn secure legitimate incomes by making these products. As of 2001, Doi Tung has been financially self-sufficient due to effective planning and management. It has been almost 10 years since Pichai Apisunthongkun, an Akha tribesman, was trained by the project. He now has his own business selling potted flowers to the Mepha Luang garden. He also manages his time to tend to his coffee plantation. He sells the cherries back to the project for additional income. By giving Pichai the opportunity and skills training, the project has helped him evolve from a hired hand to a business owner. Pichai is only one of the numerous ethnic hill tribe minorities who is now self-reliant, just as envisioned by the late Princess Mother. Once people have good basic health and can work to earn a living, education becomes the next priority. The Princess Mother believed that education is a basic human right that should be available to all people, regardless of race, gender, or class. The project places great importance on providing education that is suitable for the conditions and needs of the local community. Formal education as well as practical vocational training is provided. Arawan Sopon Amnoikit, an Akha weaver, has been working at the project for over 11 years. She recognizes that illiteracy is the root of hardship. What she wants most for her four children is the chance to have what she herself never had, an education. When the project came here and built schools, she enrolled her children right away. Today, all of her four children are in school. They are the new generation that is restoring the values and dignity to their people, just as the Princess Mother had intended.
ไม่ว่าจะเป็นชนเผ่าใดก็ตามท่านก็ให้ความสำคัญการศึกษาเท่ากันค่ะ อย่างน้อยๆก็ขอจบม.6ก็ยังดีเพราะมีแม่คนเดียวต้องช่วยแม่มาทำงานในพื้นที่เด็กตุงแห่งนี้ค่ะมาพัฒนาให้เจริญขึ้นมาตอบแทนพื้นแผ่นดินแห่งนี้ค่ะจากเดิมที่เราที่ไม่ค่อยช่วยเหลือตัวเองได้สมเด็จย่าท่านได้ช่วยเหลือเราทุกอย่างเพื่อที่จะฝึกให้เราช่วยเหลือตัวเองนะคะให้เราดำรงชีวิตอยู่ในพึ่งพาตัวเองได้
Pilot schools use the learner-centered method. The new Doi Tung special curriculum combines tribal history and heritage with modern education. This new method will cultivate smart, competent, morally responsible children who will grow up to be valuable ethical members of society. Today, the new breed of Doi Tung locals are united in their efforts to think, initiate, and some are starting to even manage their own activities. The 27 villages govern themselves. These young men from various tribes are part of a local governing body called the Mae Fa Luang Sub-District Administrative Organization. For many consecutive years, this local sub-district administrative organization has won many management awards. The organization uses democratic principles where every village is represented. Rules and regulations are set up by a village council, and every problem is addressed, especially those that are drug related.
ทุกเดือนเนี่ยเราจะคุยในเรื่องของยาเสพติดเป็นนโยบายของรัฐบาลแล้วก็ที่สมเด็จย่าไปแบ่งยาให้กับเราว่าในเมื่อดึงขึ้นมาจากคูนรกที่เสพตัดยาให้อะไรแล้วเนี่ยเราไม่ควรจะไปยุ่งกับสิ่งเหล่านี้แล้วถึงแม้เราไม่รวยเราพออยู่พอกินแล้วเนี่ยเลิกเสียเถอะขอกันนะฮะขอร่วมมือชาวบ้านให้ขอร่วมมือดีมากครับก็ไม่แน่เชื่อว่าจะได้รับขอร่วมมือถึงขนาดนี
้ This Aka Bakluay Village has proven itself with a strong council body. These village leaders set and enforce their clear drug policies.
แต่ว่าหมู่บ้านนี้มีกฎมีระเบียบอย่างนี้ถ้าสู่อย่างนี้อย่างนั้นแล้วค้าอย่างนี้แล้วไม่ให้อยู่ในหมู่บ้านนี้คือชาวบ้านก็ต้องฟังคือคณะกรรมการเข้มแข็งบ้านผมเนี่ยบ้านปากกล้วยนี่มีประชากรมี570กว่าคนเนี่ยผมพูดได้เลยว่าตรงนี้เนี่ยผู้ค้าผู้เสพไม่มี 100% ผมรับได้ครับ
The Mae Fa Luang Administrative Organization bases its work on the Princess Mother's Management Principles
ในเรื่องของการเสียสละนะครับอายุท่านเยอะแล้วก็เสียสละมาทำตรงนี้นะฮะนี่เป็นรูปแบบแล้วก็รูปแบบอย่างพระองค์ท่านก็คือไม่เลือกชนชั้นวรรณะไม่ว่าเป็นชนเผ่าไหนคือให้ความเสมอภาคและก็ให้ชาวบ้านเรียนรู้จากความเป็นจริงไม่ว่าจะเป็นเรื่องปลูกต้นไม้ปลูกกาแฟปลูกแมคคาเดเมียเนี่ยให้เรียนรู้ด้วยตัวเองและก็สามารถที่จะช่วยเหลือตัวเองได้
Man and nature can coexist when each derives benefit from the other. The locals now see the value of their natural resources. The management at Doi Tung is confident that the local people will be ready to take over the management of the project by 2017. In 2006,The Belgian government asked the Mae Fa Luang Foundation to share our experience and expertise in sustainable alternative livelihood development to help Afghanistan solve the problems of opium cultivation and poverty. The Belgian government provided the financial capital, while the Mae Fa Luang contributed the human capital. An equal partnership was struck between Thailand and Belgium. foundation set up a meeting at Doi Tung so that all the stakeholders, Afghan farmers, community leaders, the governor of Bach, Afghan senior government officials, representatives of the NGO community, as well as experts and academics from all over the world, could come together in an open discussion. The objective was to come up with a development strategy that all could accept. This would ensure commitment and cooperation by everyone right from the start. A program to develop Karakul sheep was agreed upon. The Mefa Luang staff set up tents and lived alongside local shepherds to understand and to learn about their way of life, and also to earn their trust. We had no agenda but to give, give, and give. The Sheep Bank project was officially launched in November 2006. The Mefa Luang Foundation is in the process of bringing Doi Tung's experience to help improve the livelihood of the people in Aceh, Indonesia, at their government's request. The Doi Tung Development Project now serves as a model and a knowledge center for all. Our aim is for you to take back what you see and learn here to adapt and apply these principles and methods according to the reality of your own situations in order to bring about spin-offs of similar action programs in your own communities all over the world. It can be done. Although the Princess Mother is no longer with us, her legacy of helping people to help themselves continues in the work of His Majesty the King, members of the royal family, and those of us who follow in her footsteps. In time, the future of this land and its people will be ensured by local leaders who will take charge in managing the social, economic, and environmental well-being of Doi Tung. This is the true meaning of sustainability.